Hey, brothers and sisters in the Lord, it's your sister and girl, Gina. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Praise the Lord, he is alive, amen. So I figured I would do a get ready with me since it's been a while and show you guys my Easter outfit for today. And yeah, so let's get started. Putting my primer on right now. See, moisture primer. Moisturize his face. It's a beautiful day outside today. Very cool one. I had decided to do like a playlist. I like created it today out of like so many of my songs on Spotify. Of just like songs that talk about his sacrifice, the fact that he died for us, and the fact that he's alive. I was like, let me just make a playlist. This way, this is all that I can listen to like whenever I want to for Communion Sunday or whatever. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy it. Hopefully you guys can hear me. Let me turn it down. But I have enough space on my phone because I have a vlog that I didn't post yet that I'll probably post after this. We went to go see the movie God's Not Dead, A Light in the Darkness, the other day, and I haven't posted it up yet. So I've been having issues with having space on my phone. So praying to God, I have space for that. So yeah, my outfit for today is very springy. Like, thankfully, it's a pretty good day today outside as far as weather. It's not that warm. It's like high 50s, low 60s, I believe. I'll probably try to see if I can show you guys some footage of me outside so you can see my modest outfit. So I can start showing you guys like some of like the outfits that I wear and how I try to make it modest if I'm worried about coverage. Like today, right? This is kind of seems low cut, but I have a nude tank top underneath just to make sure I have enough coverage up here, which I told you guys about. I usually get my tank tops from H&M. They have long tank tops. They usually have them like 2 for $10 or something like that. And I usually try to get them in neutral colors like black, tan, all that stuff, just so I could wear it, you know, for more coverage if need be, for up top or the bottom portion, because I am a curvy girl and I have to be cautious of that, you know what I mean? Love my curves, that's what God gave me, but you know, that's for my husband if he intends for me to be married one day, not for everybody. So I'm definitely gonna do an eyeshadow look today. But you know what? Let me put on my foundation first. Oh man, I forgot my beauty blender. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back with it. We sing hallelujah, the Lamb has overcome. Forever he is lifted high. I am not Carrie Job. I can't sing that high note. Maybe I'll even get to show you guys. If I'm not too scared to record, show you guys some clips of our service. You know, one thing I'm really appreciative of with our church is that, you know, they focus on staying in biblical context. It's not about all the different shows and different things that we can do. God has gifted us with different things, you know, to be able to sing, to be able to dance, to be able to rap unto him or whatever. But nowadays with the church, it's all about, you know, different shows and trying to like appeal to the world and be trendy and everything right now, like that, and it looks more like a concert. Stop by and fill your prescription. It looks more like a concert than it does
and earn a $5 Target coupon for 10 prescriptions filled. And while you're here, pick a church,
you know what I mean? And I'm thankful to God that God has kept our church humble by his grace alone to not focus on those things. So we like, we kind of bring the focus on the kids, where the kids will do different stuff, or we have a brother in the Lord who occasionally rhymes, and we used to have a praise and worship dance team, which I was a part of. But the other church building that we were at before is something unfortunately happened where we weren't able to no longer be there due to a fire that happened. There was like a really bad thunderstorm. So the church we've been at now for the past year and a half that we rent from, they don't have a lot of stage space, so it's kind of hard for us to do dances. I really do hope we get back into it though, because it was such a blessing to me to be a part of that. I like buildable makeup, like medium makeup. Not like too light where it's like I feel like I'm wasting my money, unless it's like every day it's like a BB cream with a little bit of color. Keep it simple dimple today and just do what I usually do. I'm about to put on my concealer right here. Holy one, so I can live. I'm so scattered brain right now. I'm like, the songs are distracting me and I want to praise the Lord, but then I'm behind and I want to hurry up and get ready and leave. I meant to do this after I put on my eyeshadow. I put on my Milani eyeshadow primer. It's really, really, really good. A little goes a long way. Like, this is like literally all I have. I've had this for like probably like a year now too. And it works well. I don't even know how I want to do my eye look today. The only thing I'm sure about is this lip gloss that I have. I also want you guys to hear the music a little bit in the background. And hopefully you'll want to praise the Lord.
Shed His blood for me.
Whatever, y'all gonna get a little bit of praise and talking at the same time. Masquerade palette by Julius Place. Gonna use this brown as a transition color. I know I kind of want to use this red too. I'll probably keep it natural and then a little bit of red because it'll go with my lip gloss.
Yes, the blood, it is my victory.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, that your blood is my victory. Shameful sin placed on him. Praise the Lord. I may have hope in eternal life. Okay. So. Thank you, Lord. Love that song. Our church usually sings that for communion on occasion. I'm gonna take this brush because it's a very precise brush. I'm gonna get this red right here. It kind of goes with my lipsticks, my lip gloss. I'm gonna try to get more because it's not as red as I want it to be. So I'm just kind of like drawing like a V and trying to be very precise. I like makeup, but I'm not a makeup artist. I really like how that came out. I've been liking lip gloss lately because it's I've been finding some that are very pigmented. I like them more so for, I think, the spring and the summer. I'm more so leaning towards that. And then the mattes, more like for the fall, or satins for the fall. Satin I can get away with for spring too. But the really matte colors, like depending on the matte lipsticks, depending on the color, I'd rather have that be for like fall, winter. Lately I've been liking like the lip glosses as it's been getting more and more towards the springtime. Let's see. I don't know how I want to do my eyes, y'all. I really don't. I'm like, do I do a shimmer? Do I not? Do I do something more matte? Even though I just said I didn't want to do matte colors. I don't know. Trying something new. Trying to do something a little different today. I have this. It's Judy Time palette. I used to watch her on YouTube. Gonna take this pink right here. Put it in a corner. Gonna take my blending brush, right? And I'm gonna go back to that red just to make sure it's more vibrant in the corner. I like it, it's very springy. I'm gonna take the small brush and get this kind of dark rose gold, kind of coppery color. I like it. Also gonna take this off a little bit. This brown right here. I really like Jeremy Camp's. He has a wonderful voice. He does have some songs that I like, but his most recent album, or the past two, I think it is, that he's done in the past year, really good.
We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome.
Let's go. Oh, man. Oh, man. Thank you, Lord. This is my jam.
Where to? Oh, no. Our God in His name, He is there. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power, power in His name. No fear, no lie can stand against us now. He is here. Whoa, whoa. He is here. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power, power in His name. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Okay. This brand mix. I have a lot of, most of my makeup that I have, you guys, are like drugstores or like cheap brands online. I don't really have too many like name brand stuff besides like my foundation. That's pretty much it. Everything else that I have, like, is stuff that is affordable that you guys might want. So I love NYX line so much. I think I definitely have a lipstick edition. I am Georgina Sewa Afri. So I'll put my full name out there, whatever. I am Gina Afri, and I have an addiction to lipsticks and lip glosses, y'all. I just love a good lip. Like, you'll see, like, I don't always wear eyeshadow, but as long as I have a good lip, that's all I care about. So I've really been liking this NYX Intense Butter Gloss. I have a few of these. I've gotten them recently. They are so pigmented for brown skin girls, or just in general, but definitely for brown skin girls. And they're moisturizing. They're not sticky, you know, and they're affordable. So this color is in
it's time for chocolate apple. And, you're free
and yeah, that's why I wanted the red eye. I mean, it's not too much red, but it's all right.
Take home cold classic, your choice of a bag duo yes. In limited edition Marimekko design.
Okay. If I put highlight, it may just be a little bit, honestly. I think I'm going to use the Golden Child Super Shock Cheek by ColourPop. They're another affordable brand, but only an online brand. Really good. That's a pal. So I just put it on a little bit. See the change fall.
Broken, now here, that's the power of the cross, see the chains fall, that's the power of the cross, see the chains fall.
So this is the end of the look, y'all. I'm spraying on my NYX Dewy Finish Spray, and ta-da! I have these bracelets from Co-host, this ring from CVS, believe it or not, and these earrings are for CVS. I love the ruffle.
So I was reading Luke 23 through 24, and it talks about Jesus's you know, him being crucified and his resurrection. And I love how detailed the book of Luke is when it talks about it. But some things that really stood out to me is verse 42 through 43 of Luke 23. Or you know what, I'll start at verse 39 to 43. And it says, and one of the malefactors, which means evildoer, I believe in the Greek, which were hanged, railed on him, saying, if thou be Christ, save thyself and us. But the other answering rebuked him, saying, does not thou fear God, seeing that thou art in the same condition, the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds, but this man has done nothing wrong. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. And that's just so comforting that, like, even though he, you know, right before he's about to die, because he confessed that Jesus Christ was Lord. He recognized that. He saw that. He believed in faith. He saw the wickedness of his own heart. He was like, I deserve to be on this cross. You deserve to be on this cross. Not this man. He is truly Christ in the flesh. And the fact that he repented, he recognized his sins and repented. And Christ said, today you'll be with me in paradise. That's just so comforting. Like, thank you, Lord, that, like, and our wickedness, Lord God, as long as we repent of our wickedness unto you, our sinfulness, that we're a wretched sinner in need of your grace, in need of your love, and you alone are our righteousness, and through you alone are we justified. You know, we have eternal life. That the Lord allowed him to be with him in heaven that day. That's just so comforting. Luke 24:7 says, saying, the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day rise again. Just reminding them who didn't believe you know, what's crazy is verse 10 and 11. It says, it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna and Mary, the mother of James, and other women that were with them, which is great that the Bible highlights that, because at that time they didn't want to, you know, they really shunned women and looked at them as really like lesser than, but Christ respected women, you know what I mean? And they could have been killed for even mentioning women, seeing that Christ was alive at the tomb, but they mentioned it anyway because of the, obviously the Lord allowed them to be able to mention it. But, you know, it says that, you know, they were with James and they told the apostles about these things that Christ had already told them about while they were following him. And yet, it says in verse 11, and their words seemed to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. And, you know, when I read that, I was like, wow, you know, it was just a reminder that just because some people claim that they're walking with the Lord, if they just look at the Bible as, you know, or God's word saying is just, oh, I know that, I've heard that before. You know, we can sometimes get stagnant in our walk and mundane in our walk, you know, where we really think highly of ourselves because we've been walking with the Lord for so long. But we daily need the word of God. We daily need to be believing it. You know what I mean? We daily need to be asking the Lord. I know even for myself to refresh my heart, to thirst after his word, to want to hear it, that it would come alive to me, that it would be, you know, above everything else, that it would be very important to me, and that I would know that it's true and truly believe, you know. But it's just crazy just seeing that contrast, you know what I mean, of the fact of, you know, Barabbas, I believe it was, being about to be killed, but seeing that he was God in the flesh, repented and was with the Lord. And yet the disciples who really said, you know, who followed his teachings, who seen his miracles, yet they were slow to believe. That's just crazy, you know what I mean? It really shows that we have to, you know, examine our hearts and our walk, that we don't get to that place of having unbelief. One thing I love too is, you know, Luke 24, when Jesus appears to them, you know, it really talks about scripture being fulfilled. Like, it doesn't just emphasize on the fact that Christ was risen. Like, of course, like, that's our hope, that's our victory. Not just that he died for us, but the fact that he's alive. But also the fact that, you know, it says that Christ expounded the scriptures to them, you know, in verse 31 through 32. And it says, and their eyes were open, and they knew him, and he vanished out of their sight. And they said one to another, did not our hearts burn within us while we talked to him? While, you know, he talked with us, by the way. And while he opened to us the scriptures, they were like amazed at the fact that at that time, like, God, Jesus blinded them from knowing that he was Christ, you know, that he was himself there, and then revealed it later on. But, you know, it says, wow, like, you know, didn't our hearts burn within us to hear what he was saying? You know, Lord, give us that thirst that we would really hope in your word, that it would be alive to us, that it would be everything, that we would know that it's the truth and there is no other way. The only truth, that Christ is the living truth. And then in chapter Luke 24, verse 44, it says, and he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerning me. Then he opened their understanding that they might understand the scriptures. And that's just amazing right there. He opened their understanding. God opens our understanding to his word. If ever we're troubled, or if ever we're not understanding certain scriptures, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, makes the word of God comes alive to us and gives us new understanding. I'm going to keep reading though. Verse 46 in Luke 24. And said unto them, this is written, and thus it behold Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. and you are witnesses of these things. And behold, I send the promise of the Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. And that's just comforting. And then when it talks about when Jesus ascended into heaven in verse 52 through 53, it says, and they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy and were continually in the temple praising and blessing God. See, sometimes, you know, even though Christ came in the flesh, you know, and they saw him and they were like, wow, like he's really here. You know, I love how it emphasizes that, like, Christ pointed everything back to the word. This is, I fulfilled what God said in his word. And he, you know, spoke to them scripture, you know what I mean? From the Old Testament to up until that point of him being alive, you know, it's just so amazing. Like, sometimes, you know, as I said in my video about Joy Behar or whatever, you know, we look for signs and wonders and visions and dreams and all those things, but the word of God is really all that we need. Christ was a living word. He came to fulfill that. He died and he rose again for you and for me. So I pray that you would just know that he is alive, that he is true, that he is the only way. And, you know, as I call it, my church calls it, it's Resurrection Sunday. You know, not just, you know, Easter, whether you believe it's pagan or whatever. I try to emphasize saying Resurrection Sunday because he is risen. Praise him.
Let's go outside. Here I am. Look at me. It's freezing outside and I'm trying to act cute. But I'm trying to do this for y'all so that it's not modestly beautiful without me not showing y'all my outfits. So I have a long tank top underneath to make sure I have more coverage since I'm a curvy girl and I'm wearing light pants. You know, I don't want the attention to be drawn to the wrong place. So that is a tip for y'all. I also have these cute nude sandaled heels that I got from DSW. I definitely want to get them in black too. They're so easy to walk in. I'm flat-footed, so I need heels that have enough support, that are thicker heels, not something skinny or too high. I love this ruffled shirt. I love floral prints, but I'm very picky with that. I like the tropical floral print. And I love the ruffles on the side. The shirt was only $10.99. I was on the mission to go to the store to only get a nice shirt. It's starting to freeze outside, so I'm starting to put my coat on. This is exactly why my voice is a little bit raspy right now. I should not have did this to myself. But I love y'all enough that I wanted to record this video for you guys. So yeah, this is pretty much the end of the video. I am tying my belt this way because it gives me more of a shape. Not in a bad way to bring wrong attention, but, you know, just so it's complimenting. So this is the end of the video. I probably might show you guys some clips of some of the things from our service. God bless you guys. Bye. Jesus.